ladies, welcome to this service celebrating the marriage of Luke and Abigail. Why don't you sit down for a moment? It's great to see you all. You're all very welcome. Anybody here from Abigail's family? Bit of a lame effort, actually. Anyone here from Luke's family? Yeah, a bit better. Of course, this is one of those days, it's not just a coming together of families, there's also a church family. So anyone here from the Faversham Baptist Church? Yay! A bit rowdy, isn't it? And how about some Mary of Charity? Anyone friends of the bride or groom? Anyone here? Anyone wandered in off the street wondering what's going on? Everyone, it doesn't matter who you are, every one of you is very welcome here this afternoon in this service. This is one of life's great moments, a time of solemn commitment, good wishes, feasting and joy. The Bible tells us how Jesus shared in such an occasion at Cana, and there he gave a sign of new beginnings by turning water into wine. For Christian people, marriage is also an invitation to share together in the life of Jesus Christ. It's based on a solemn, public and lifelong covenant, which we are about to witness this afternoon, declared and celebrated in the presence of God and all of us here. On their wedding day, Luke and Abby, they will face each other, not yet, make their promises and receive God's blessing. We will ask God to bless them greatly, that their marriage may be filled with joy, that he will bring them closer to one another, and that they would be ever more open to him whose love gives meaning to theirs. The Bible says that God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. Now, I hope you've got an order of service there, and you will have found that it tumbles up very usefully as a fan. I'm sure you've discovered that already, so if you're a bit hot, you can always do that. But that tells us where we're going and what we're doing. We're about to sing in a moment. We're going to sing three times during the service. And at those moments, I will invite you to stand. The words will magically appear over here. And there will be a recording. And I invite you, if you know the songs, to sing along with those recordings. If you don't, it's no problem. Just enjoy it. If nothing else, you're getting to stretch your legs as you stand up. That's what we're about to do. But before we sing, let me just say, if you haven't seen the notice and you've got one of these, we'd like you to turn it off. So as we start the scene, maybe if you haven't already done so, you'd like to turn your mic off. That would be terrific. This is the moment, right now, and we all want to be fully here and part of it. So let's stand to sing. This first song is called Counting Every Blessing by Red Collective, and if you know it, please do sing along. Let's stand together. Oh, 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 oh.
Oh, 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 oh. I was blind, now I'm seeing in color. I was dead, now I'm living forever. I felt that you were my redeemer. I feel blessed beyond all measure. I was lost, now I'm found by Father. I've been changed from a ruin to treasure. I've been given a hope and a future. I've been blessed beyond all measure. I am counting every blessing, counting every blessing, letting go and trusting where I cannot see. I am counting every blessing, counting every blessing. Show me every season you have given to me. Oh, 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 oh. You were there in the valley of shadows. You were there in the depth of my sorrows. You my strength, my for tomorrow. I've been blessed beyond all measure. I am counting every blessing, counting every blessing.
Two balloons, and together our direction is up. The chances are we've found our soulmate.
Thank you. That's very good. Now, I'm sure you're enjoying the back view of Luke and Abby at the moment. And so that they don't need to stand up for too long, this part is the heart of the marriage ceremony. We're going to get them married, as a certain bishop might say, and did say a few weeks ago at the royal wedding. That's the important bit of the afternoon. Marriage, of course, is a gift of God in creation through which husband and wife may know the grace of God. It is given that as a man and woman grow together in love and trust, they shall be united with one another in heart and body and mind, just as Jesus Christ is united with the church. The gift of marriage brings husband and wife together in joyful commitment to the end of their lives. It's given as the foundation of family life, in which children are born and nurtured, and in which each family member, in good times and in bad, may find strength, companionship, and comfort, and grow to maturity in love. There are a number of questions that you will need to answer in the next few minutes. And I ask you to do that loudly so everyone can hear you. If you're facing that way, so nice and loud, bounce it off the wall back to them. First, answers you do. I hope. Otherwise, we'll probably go home. Luke and Abby, do you come here today because you believe Christian marriage to be God's gift and calling to you? Do you intend that with God's help, you will do all that you can to encourage one another in the faith? And that as disciples of Jesus Christ, you will seek to live under his control and promote his kingdom in the world by the use of your home, your time, and whatever gifts God gives you.
We do.
That's good to hear. Marriage is a sign of unity and loyalty which all should uphold and honour. It enriches society and strengthens community. No one should enter into it carelessly, lightly, or selfishly, but reverently, responsibly, and after serious thought. Before Abby and Luke are married, I am required to ask anyone present who can show any reason why they may not legally be married to declare it now. Luke and Abby, you relieved? The vows that you are about to take are to be made in the presence of God, who is the judge of all and knows all the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you know of any reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now. So, after me, please. I do solemnly declare, that I know not, of any lawful impediment, why I, Luke Christian Scarfe,
may not be joined in matrimony,
to Abigail Ione Cook.
I do solemnly declare
that I know not
of any lawful impediment
why I, Abigail Ione
Cook,
may not be joined in matrimony to Luke Christian Scarfe. Luke, are you willing to give yourself in Christian marriage to Abby?
I am.
Will you? I will. Will you love her and comfort her, honour and keep her in sickness and in health, and be faithful to her as long as you both live?
I will.
Abby, are you willing to give yourself in Christian marriage to Luke? Will you love him and comfort him, honour and keep him in sickness and in health, and be faithful to him as long as you both live? Right. Now this is interesting. We come to a part of the ceremony called the giving away. This is where I normally ask the father of the bride, who may well be standing over here somewhere, but isn't on this occasion. He's standing where I'm standing. I know. I think I need to wear a different hat just for the moment. Can I just invite my wife just for one moment? I think you need to be me. And I'll be me.
Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
I do. Wonderful. We're there. We're nearly facing each other, but not quite yet. Let me address those of you who are here as family members, Luke and Abigail's family. Do you give your love and blessing to this new family, and do you promise in good times and bad to do everything in your power to support them in their marriage? If you do, would you please stand? Thank you. And everyone else, all those who are friends of this couple, witnessing these vows this afternoon, will you do everything in your power to support Luke and Abby in their marriage? As a sign that you will, please, would you stand? I, Luke Christian Scarfe.
I, Luke Christian Scarfe.
Take you, Abigail Ione Cook.
Take you, Abigail Ione Cook.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and
until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
And in the presence of God.
And in the presence of God.
And this congregation.
And this congregation.
I give you my word.
I give you my word.
I, Abigail Ione Cook.
I, Abigail Ione Cook.
Take you, Luke Christian Scarfe.
Take you, Luke Christian Scarfe.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to
hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until we are parted by death, and in the presence of God and this congregation, I give you my word. As a token of the covenant into which you have entered, these rings are given and received. God of steadfast love, by your blessing, may these rings be to Luke and Abby symbols of the vow they have made this day, and of the covenant into which they have entered. By your grace, help them to be faithful to each other in unbroken love through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I give you this ring.
Give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body I honour you.
With my body I honour you.
All that I am I give to you.
All that I am I give to you.
And all that I have I share with you.
And all that I have I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
I give you this ring as a sign of our marriage. With my body I honour you. All that I am I give to you. And all that I have I share with you. Within the love of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Luke and Abby have solemnly declared in the presence of God and this congregation that they will live together in Christian marriage. They have made promises to one another and symbolised their marriage by joining hands and by giving and receiving rings. I therefore pronounce them husband and wife in the name of the God, of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Those whom God has joined together, let no one separate. You may now. to rapturous applause. This is right. Standing, and then we can sit again. Blessed be God the Father, who gives joy to the bridegroom and bride. Blessed be the God of the wedding feast, who turns water into wine. Blessed be the God of love and loyalty, who makes from two one new creation. Luke and Abby, receive God's blessing. Carry God's love with you as you go, and call upon Him constantly. May God give you grace and peace in your new life together. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up the light of His countenance upon you and give you His peace. Amen.
Amen.
Please, do be seated. We have witnessed the vows, the marriage has taken place, we have asked God's blessing. We're going to do, the first thing we're going to do right now is continue to pray just for a couple of moments for these two people. It's the greatest gift we can really give to them as we pray for them. I'm going to suggest, if this is at all possible, it's Dennis here. Dennis, can you get out for a moment? I haven't pre-warned you of this. Keith, would you be prepared to just come forward for a moment? You're going to be in a moment, I know, but would you mind? Would you mind just coming here? All I'm wanting to do is just a couple of people around the back of these two here, if you would. Because I'm going to lead us in some prayer. I'm going to lead us just a quiet moment, and if someone else wants to pray loudly so we can hear, that's fine. Just a short prayer for these two, that's great. No one needs to. If you don't want to, that's fine. But it's not me praying for them, it's us. And so these three, so say wise men, you're not quite wise men. Well, you're all wise, but not all men. Sort of represents, just for a moment, the fact that we're all in this. It'd be a bit unseemly for all of us to be here, but we represent everyone. Is that okay? Sort of church, communities, family, let's pray. If you want to lead us just briefly, feel free.
Loving Father, we thank you for Luke and for Abigail, and we thank you for everything that has brought them to this day, for all the love they've shared over the years, for their commitment to each other. And we pray for their future happiness together and ask that you will bless them abundantly. In your name.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful day that we have today to celebrate this marriage between Luke and Abigail. May their life be continuously happy and full of good love given from both of them to each other. In the name of our Father, amen.
Amen.
Father God, in the years to come, we pray that when times are tough, that they will remember to look to you as the source of all love, and that you are the example that they are following in their love for one another. Pray that you would keep them together and that you would bless them in the years to come. Amen.
Gracious God, we thank you for the promise and for the hope and for the love of this day. We pray for Abigail and Luke as they share together their life. May their love grow deeper and stronger amid all the uncertainties and the twists and turns of the life they will share. May they be to each other both strong and gentle, abounding in forgiveness and hope. May your love always lift their heads to the heavens whilst their feet remain deeply rooted in the earth. May they always honour you as the one who first loved them and inspired them to love one another, the one who brought them together and loves us all with an everlasting love. And may each of us here this day be given new hope in the commitment to love and be affirmed in our own love for others. We pray all of this in the name of Jesus. Amen. We're going to stand and sing again, words on the screen. Again, some of you will know the song. Please do join in. If you don't, feel free to tap your foot or take off your shoes and hum. Would you like to stand?
Thank you.
hope to every heart. We are lost without your glory. We are lost without you, God. Be the fire that burns within us, flames of love that purify. Send your power and your salvation. Let us see your kingdom come.
This is how God showed his love amongst us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him. This is love, not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins. Dear friends, since God loved us, we also ought to love one another. For no one has seen God, but if we love one another, God lives in us, and his love is made complete in us.
Thank you, Keith. Well, allow me to say to you now, Luke and Abigail, what is true of everyone in your position. You are now sat next to the person, statistically speaking, most likely to kill you.
Yeah.
Just a warning. You're married! You could be a bit more excited. That'll come later. We'll have time for that. You're married. The hard work, and you know this. You know this. We've talked about this. Now the hard work begins. Because marriage is a delight, it's a joy, but it is hard work. Even on a day like today, most of us are realistic enough to know that life isn't always a happy ever after thing. That's what today is about, really, and we love it. But it's a grind as well. It's difficult. There are bad days. There are bad moments. There are bad seasons. Life is a journey of joys and sorrows. It's about people and relationships, and that is messy. Most of all, it's about love. Real love. Gritty, determined, resilient love. It's the kind of love that Bishop Michael Curry was talking about at Harry and Meghan's wedding just a few weeks ago. He said, we're made by the power of love. Our lives are meant to be lived in that love. That's why we're here. There's power in love to help and heal when nothing else can. There's power in love to lift up and liberate when nothing else can. There's power in love to show us the way to live. I'm not going to do the whole thing. But he can't stir things up a little bit. It's the kind of love, of course, that we read about in the Bible. We read about in 1 Corinthians, and you've nicely done up and down here. I hope people saw as they were in, so with the whole thing up and down the chairs there. Some love that Keith has just read to us from 1 John chapter 4. I know a lot of us possibly switch off a bit, because you do, don't you? So I just want to, just for a few moments, remind us what it says here. And Keith read it to us. Dear friends, let us love one another. Why? For love comes from God. What's the source of love? Where does love come from? It's God himself. The foundation for marriage. The foundation for any relationship. Love. And that comes from God. A few moments ago, you said those fateful words. I will. Luke, you could have said, I won't. You could have turned around and gone home. Glad you didn't. Everyone else is. Been a bit of a downer if you had. Abby, when I said, will you have this man, you could have said, oh, yes, please. But I think that would have been a bit too enthusiastic for the circumstances. And you didn't do that. In the old service, the question was, wilt thou? To which the obvious answer is, I've already wilted it, thank you very much. But in fact, you both got the words exactly right. You said it all in the right places. I will, nicely and accurately. In Christian marriage, though, there is a third person who says, I will. You say it, Luke, Abby, you say it. The question, will you? And God says, I will. He's got a great deal to do with the happiness of your marriage. Fortunately, lots of us here who know God know that one of his favourite words is yes. So he said, I will as well as you. His nature is to be creative and loving. He demonstrated that love by creating us and by sending Jesus into the world. Again, Keith read for us. Love comes from God. This is how God showed his love among us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him. On the cross, Jesus opened his arms wide and said, I love you. Father, forgive them. He gave himself up for me and for you and for everyone with every ounce of his blood, every drop. On the cross, Jesus said to you what you've just said to one another. All that I am, I give to you. And all that I have, I share with you. If we want to see what is the most important wedding vow, and I don't want to take it away from you guys, but it is the one when we look at the cross that we see when Jesus says to you, I will. It's Jesus' promise to us that makes our relationships. It's his love that is the source of our love. That's the ultimate wedding. Jesus sharing everything for you, with you, free, and forever. In baptism, and that's a kind of wedding in a weird kind of way, can't go into that right now, we say, yes, we accept that from Jesus. You share with him all your failures, all your shame, all your sins. We've generously shared this with Jesus, and he's taken it on board. He absorbs all of that. His I will towers above ours, and it's because love comes from God. It's the bedrock of marriage, it's the bedrock of your marriage. Your love isn't the foundation of this. Marvellous though that is, we'll jump up and down and celebrate it today. But it's his love. That's where it comes from. And then we have to love one another. So when we get it right, we get the order right, love comes from God, then this passage says we should love one another. Dear friends, let's do that. If we don't love, we don't know God, because he is love. We love one another. And this isn't just about marriage today, it's about any kind of Christian or other relationship. Particularly written at the time to early Christian community, really, people living in not in churches as we know them, but together, sharing their lives, not necessarily from the same families, but all together believing they're part of God's family together. And it's applicable to marriage as well, because we love one another only with God. This goes beyond the narrow definitions of our Western individualism. You're going to have a wonderful marriage, make a great home, but that's there to bless other people. It's love for one another, but it's love that you will be able to share. How do we view relationships these days? We tend to think of relationships as a way of finding one person in particular who will save us from the bother of dealing with people in general. Just couple up on the sofa with your Marks and Spencer's 2 meals for a tenner and watch box sets until you die. No, no. God's love is meant for sharing, and I know that you will do that as well. Your marriage is very personal, of course, but it's not privatised. It belongs to the community. And the last thing I want to say, God's love is made complete in us. Keith read that. I don't know if you noticed. God's love is made complete in us. You see, it's kind of like a circle. It all has to join up. Love comes from God, and we love one another, and then love is made complete. What does that mean? Well, it means this. It means that, unfortunately, we're not as good at love as we think we are. Because although we can have great feelings and try really hard, we often mess up in our relationships with one another. And we hurt one another, we upset one another, we say things and we do things we don't really mean to, but somehow it just ends up as a bit of a mess. That's not love. That's not from God. That's the sort of thing that I can achieve perfectly well on my own, thank you very much. And that's why I so much need God's love to share. And when we're full of God's love, it pushes out all of that. Now, I don't know what's in store later on at the reception. I'm imagining perhaps marble staircases, pink flamingos, with trays of bolivars. Is that more room? I don't know. Naturally, of course, there'd be a champagne fountain. You know, one of those things where it's got all those glasses and all the rest of it? That would be great for many reasons, not least of which it illustrates what I'm trying to say here. That somehow, in embracing God's love and allowing that to push out all the stuff that we get caught up in, it makes that love absolutely complete. It's a bit like pouring in the champagne on the top glass, and then it starts to filter down and overflow into the ones underneath it, and down and down and down it comes. It's like God pours out his love, and he pours it onto and into Jesus, and then it pours and floods over from him into us, those of us who are gathered around Jesus, and then it pours out from us, down and down and down and down, and we're filled, and his love is made complete. Our relationships aren't always like that, and yours will be fine. But they're not. There's an American psychologist who, he's counseled hundreds of couples in his life, and he says, you know, a lot of the couples he sees are like a tick on a dog relationship. One partner just sucking the life out of the other. That's bad enough, he says. But many couples he sees are like two ticks and no dog. And you know, we may not be the worst at it here, but we all struggle with this. It's only God's love when it fills us and overflows, then it's all complete and it's how it's meant to be. So let me just finally say, God is love. This passage actually says that. You know, in case we haven't got the point, I think we've got the point, haven't we? It's all about love and it's God's love and it's... But God actually is love. Let me just say, we get that wrong if we turn it around. Love is not God. If we chase after a particular view of love, we haven't got it. We haven't got it. We live in an obsessed society. Virtually every film, every TV show, every novel, every pop song is obsessed with the joy of falling in love and getting together. If only it were that simple. I'm not knocking that. That's okay. But you see, love is not God. That's not the ultimate. When we seek love above all else, we fail, we fall short, we make a mess. But when we seek God above all else, then we find love because God is love. There's a lot of great relationship advice out there. Listen to it. It's not all bad. I've given you some myself. But you know, this is most revolutionary of all. God is love, and what has he given you? Himself. The advice that you get will not be better than that. Back to Jesus on the cross. He's joined you together in love because of what he's done in Jesus. He's given you himself. He is love. Your experience of love will go up and down. But he will be. Some days, Luke, you'll get up and you'll think, I'm the luckiest guy in the world. She's perfect in every respect. I wouldn't change a thing. Won't always be like that. Some days will be like that. And some days, Abby, you'll wake up and think, what kind of creature have I married? How does a human being end up like this? What's the matter with it? Listen, let me tell you, that's perfectly normal. Welcome to marriage. And it works both ways. I'm not making a point here. It works both ways. Just illustration. Your experience of love will vary. Our experience of love varies, but God's love is constant. It's true for us all. God is real. God loves you. God wants the best for you. Believe that. I do, said Chris Pratt, the actor, on Monday. And I do as well. Many of us aren't sure of what we believe, but there is eternity in our hearts. There's a sense of something beyond ourselves, a recognition that love is what it's all about. But we often mess up. We hurt each other. Well, here's the answer. God is love. Our experience will ebb and flow. We could all do with knowing that God is real and loves us. We could all do with that unfailing, unconditional love. It's the same God who is pure love, perfect love, who has joined these two together, who wants to join us all, you, me, each of us, and to say, I will. He wants to say, all that I am I give to you, all that I have I share with you. This is the one who made his vow on the cross. For better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, through death and beyond. He's yours. He's ours. It will happen. He's there if we want it. Thank you for sharing your day with us so much. We wish you every blessing from this day on. Our prayer is that you will know that love that comes from God and share it, and that love may complete. And even more than that, we will know the God who himself is love at the heart of your marriage. We're going to sing again. We're going to stand and sing, after which these two lovely people and the bridal party will be disappearing from view. We'll be going back there to sign registers and so on for maybe 8 or 9 minutes, something like that. During that time, you will be able to watch the video that a couple of here have prepared for us. Enjoy some interesting and embarrassing pictures of Luke and Abby. And then we'll be back to finish the service together. But before all of that, we're going to stand one last time and sing Words on the Screen, Matt Redman's song, 10,000 Reasons.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
be seated, and we shall be back shortly.
The Bible says, as God's own, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, and patience. Bear with one another and forgive one another, as the Lord has forgiven you, and crown all these things with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. So today we pray for Abby and Luke, and for all of us, that the grace of Christ would attend us, that the love of God would surround us, that the Holy Spirit would keep us, that we might live in faith, abounded in hope, and grow in love, now and always. Amen. In a moment, the bridal procession will pass. I ask you, please, if you would just to stay in your seats. There's a couple of photographs that need to take place over on this side of the building. If you need to get out in an emergency, please leave through that door. But if you could just stay seated until we're told that those photos are taking place, the things that are happening out there, we'd be very appreciative. 2 or 3 minutes, that's all it will be. Okay? I invite you now, please, to stand again. If you would, if you're able to do so, please stand.